Hello, so I'm Alexandra Spalato. I'm born and raised in France, but I live in the beautiful Spanish island of Mallorca. I'm a freelance web developer and entrepreneur and a WordPress expert and contractor at Codeable. And in 2018, I attended a full-stack JavaScript bootcamp in Barcelona, full-time, 3 months. I loved it, and after that, I badly wanted to work with JavaScript in React. And guess what? I found Gatsby to be the perfect bridge between my two worlds, WordPress and JavaScript. And I've already been so much rewarded by working with Gatsby, first being here in front of you, I'm super happy, and participating to really nice projects like Gatsby WP themes, where I've been porting the Tableau theme to WordPress, and speaking at the JavaScript for WordPress conference, and now I'm planning to do Gatsby WordPress themes. So you can find me at alexandraspalato.com. So we are going to look in the benefits of using WordPress as source for Gatsby, and we are going to build a site using WordPress, Gatsby, and WpGraphQL. And we are going to focus on using ACF, Advanced Custom Field, which is a very powerful WordPress plugin with the WpGraphQL ACF plugin, and we will explore the power of the flexible content, which is a special field of ACF, and we will build a custom builder with it. By the way, who is working with WordPress? Okay, and who has used WordPress with Gatsby already? Okay, nice. Okay, so what are the benefits of using WordPress as source for Gatsby? So first, WordPress is free and open source. It's flexible and powerful. And of course, WordPress is 34% of all websites in the world, and that's huge. So it means that you can have many clients that will want to switch their front end to Gatsby to enjoy all the speed and security and the goodness that Gatsby build, and you don't need to migrate the data to another CMS, and they will not need to learn another back office, because the WordPress back office, it's easy and intuitive to use. That's why so many people love it. So why WP GraphQL? So the Gatsby source WordPress plugin, it's only a wrapper around the REST API, and WP GraphQL brings the real power of GraphQL to WordPress, and it easily exposes both default and custom data in WordPress, and of course, it's a lot of faster than the REST API. So we're going to make a test and make a huge query of 100 posts with the REST API here. It's the Wi-Fi works. Anyway, so REST, it's taking time because it's bringing all the data. And now let's look at it with GraphQL. Normally it's a lot of faster. Anyway, you can test it at home, and I have put some screenshots here. Okay, normally it's faster, but the Wi-Fi is like, oh, it's everything is there. So GraphQL brings only the data you need and that you ask. So of course, it's a lot of faster. Okay, now we are going to install and config the necessary plugins. So WP GraphQL and Webhook Netlify Deploy. So Webhook Netlify Deploy allows you to, when you publish content or modify content inside WordPress, you just have to push a button, so here, and it will deploy your website in Netlify. Well, when you have already before in Netlify, then the change, it will be automatically deployed on Netlify, which is great for clients that are not tech savvy. They just have to click there, and they have it deployed. So now we are going to create a config file at the root of our project, and we will place our WordPress URL here. And then we are going to install the Gatsby source GraphQL plugin. So first in the console, and then in the Gatsby config file, we give some option. We give a type name and a field name to retrieve it in the Explorer. Here I have given WP GraphQL, but you can call it WordPress if you want. And then the URL that we bring from the config and slash GraphQL. So now let's look into the Explorer how it looks. So if we go here, we have a tab WpGraphQL, and here we can see all our WordPress data that is ready to be queried. So it's really great. You can see the menus, the pages, the post, everything is there. Here it's a little GIF I have made. And now we are going to create and use custom post types. So WordPress is much more than a blog provider. And thanks to custom post types and custom field, we can really build any type of website and very complex back office. So for that, we are going to install two plugins, custom post type UI and WpGraphQL custom post type UI. We could do it that with PHP code, but let's do it faster with some plugins. So let me show you in the back office. Where is it? Okay. Here. So I have created a post type named projects. And here we tell GraphQL to show it in GraphQL, and we give a single name and a parent name to find it in the Explorer. So let's look in the Explorer. And here we can find our projects. And let's get the titles. Okay, so our projects are there, so we can query them. Now I'm going to show you how to download the image from WordPress to Gatsby in order to use them with Gatsby image and have all this optimization. So first we are going to install the Gatsby source file system and give it some options to tell where are our image directory and of course to create an image directory. And then this is into Gatsby node. We are going to require the create remote file node from Gatsby source system, and we are going to create new fields on the WpGraphQL media item that could be called WordPress media item if you have named it differently. So we create a new field named image file, and we can retrieve it here in the Explorer. So here in my projects, if I go to featured image and image file, it's there. And child image sharp. So I have all what I need to use the Gatsby image. So let's do it. So we create a Gatsby image component, and we import the plugin Gatsby image. And in this component, we create a fragment that we will use then in the when we want to use this this image component. We bring this fragment and we pass an image prop where I can pass here it's a featured image, but I can use it with other components with custom fields and other image fields. So let's look at it in real in my demo. Here I've built a blog and you see it's using Gatsby image. If we go to the next page, you can see the trace SVG. So all the images are in Gatsby image here. Okay, now we are going to create posts and pages, but I don't have time to show you all this code. However, you can find all the code in my repo along too with menu and pagination, so you can play and explore this code to see how it works. You can also look at my talk at JavaScript for WordPress conference where the process is much more detailed. Okay, now we are going to dive in ACF, Advanced Custom Field, and WpGraphQL ACF. So have you, some of you already use and work with ACF? With WordPress? Okay, and have you used ACF with Gatsby? Okay, nice. Okay, so we are going to install the required plugins, so advanced custom fields, ACF flexible content models. This one is not mandatory, but it really makes a nice UI. And of course, WpGraphQL ACF. We are going to create some custom fields. So here we create a project URL. So we need to associate this custom field to the post type project. And then we need to tick to show it in GraphQL and give it a name, so project fields. And then we are going to retrieve it in our Explorer. So here, project fields and URL, and here they are. So this is a simple field. Okay, so flexible content. The flexible content is a very powerful field, and you can really build very complex and advanced back office, and you can render it in Gatsby. So I'm going to show you a back office I did for a client a few years ago. This client wanted something very flexible in order to use very different sites with the same theme and without coding. So this one I have not made it in Gatsby, but it could be done. So here you can see I can have new layouts, I can drag and drop them, and here you see I can order things with all the settings I want. The content here I have allowed to choose a number of columns. Well, you can do whatever you want, and now you can render it in Gatsby. So that's really very, very powerful. So we are going to create some flexible content fields. So in the back office, let me show you. Here are the content. So flexible layouts. So here I have associated to the page post type, and we create a field. Okay, where is it? Okay, I have to open them. So field type flexible content, and then I create different layouts. I have created the projects block, and here you can see I display my projects inside this block with a relationship field, which is also another special field of ACF. Okay, so now in the Explorer, we get an array of all the possible types, which are the possible layouts from our flexible content. So, and we are going to use a fragment, this is the fragment, to say which field we want. With the fragment, we're going to tell GraphQL, if at execution time the data is this type name, I want these fields back, and if it's this other type name, I want these other fields back. So into the code, we are going to create a React component for each type block of layout. Inside this, this is the component, so inside the component, we are going to create a fragment that will bring the necessary data. And in our page query, we are going to bring to reuse this fragment. Then with a switch statement, we are going to map around all these possible layouts and to display the right ones. Okay, so now it's time for a live demo. So, oops. Oh, sorry. Sorry. Okay, let's go back to the live demo. Okay, so I have this project I have built, and for the moment we have a blank home. So let's create a home page with the flexible content. Okay, so let's have a heading that, okay, about, oh, sorry. Let's say it's a H1. Make it centered. Then let's have a content block. So let's have a paragraph here. Okay. Now let's have a button. and we are going to the About page. This button will be primary, and we want it centered. Let's have an image now, which will work with Gatsby image, of course. Oh, I also put every time a class and ID, so it allows you to style it differently because you are going to reuse this block, and an ID so you can make scroll on one page, for example. And now let's have our projects block. So projects, my awesome projects. Let's have some text. And now you can see we have here all of our projects. So we can display all or only some of them. OK, let's have another button. This one, we want it to be secondary. Oops. And we want it to link to the typography page. OK. And we want it centered. OK, now we have our page. Let's update. And let's rebuild our project. So if it was a live website, I'm working locally because of the Wi-Fi problems, but if it was live and already deployed on Netlify, we could just tick the deploy Netlify button, and it will be online a few minutes after, depending on the size of the website. So it's building. Okay, it's ready, so let's look at it. So let's rebuild here, and everything is here. So the heading, the content, the button, the image, and our projects. By the way, everything is styled by theme UI, so you can also look at it on the repository. And the links work, so everything works. Nice. Okay, so in we're finished. So in conclusion, pairing Gatsby and WordPress and connecting them through WpGraphQL is really groundbreaking, as it brings all of the blazingly fast and optimized features of Gatsby and the easy and intuitive CMS capabilities of WordPress together. So we invite you to celebrate our wedding, WordPress and Gatsby, officiated by WpGraphQL. Thanks to Jason Ball, by the way, for creating it. Jason is not there, but really a big thank you to him. And here you can find all the links. So this is the repo. By the way, this is a website I'm building for myself, so it will evolve, but feel free to use it for yourself and play with it, fork it, etc. Here you have the data for all the custom fields and custom post types, so you can make a fresh WordPress install and install that to have the same install I myself to play. Here are the slides, the docs on WpGraphQL, and information about me. Thank you very much.